Hi, I'm Jason from NurtureKit, NurtureKit.co, and today we're going to talk about email deliverability, specifically email authentication. I want to walk you through setting up a verified sending domain on ConvertKit. So when you log into your ConvertKit account, you're going to go over to settings. Then you're going to scroll down to email. And you're going to see verified sending domains. Okay, so what you're going to do is click on verify your domain, and then you're going to want to put in your domain name. And then you're going to get these two results here. Now, this is a set of DNS records that you have to then log into your registrar and update. You have to create two CNAME records where the name or the host, depending on your registrar's setup, is this. And then you're going to have to put in the value of this for each one. It's best to click on these icons here, make sure you get the whole thing copied to your clipboard, and then you're going to come back and click on this validate button. So I'm going to go update this, and we're going to see if when I come back, we click validate and we're good to go. So ConvertKit just released this integration that I'm going to test out in real time here. So we're going to see how this works. But basically what it does is it takes the final bit, which was left up to you, to take the records that ConvertKit gives you for the verified sending domains, and then going into your own DNS and registrar and update everything. Well, ConvertKit integrated now with a tool that basically does it all from the screen. So we're going to work on this together, and I'm going to verify a domain here. So let's click on this. We're going to verify another domain that I have. And the reason why I'm picking this is because it's a little bit more of a complex domain. So if it nails this, it probably will have no problem doing it for you. Okay. So I'm going to click on set this up for me. Let's see what happens. Easy. So it's now looking at it, and it did get it right. Okay, so it did find it. Awesome, actually. Pretty cool. So I'm going to log in. All right, so I logged in, and it did it. So we'll see how well this worked. I didn't even have to insert anything other than logging into my DNS, which happens to be at Route 53. So let's press done, validating now. And it says that it's valid. I got the check mark and I'm good to go. So this couldn't be even more easy. ConvertKit nailed this. So go ahead, verify your domain on ConvertKit, and in the next bit, we're going to talk about how we can test it outside of ConvertKit so that we make sure that everything works. So I've gone ahead and set those up in the registrar. It could take up to 24 or 48 hours for that to happen, but a lot of times it doesn't take as long. And so what you're going to do is click this validate button. If it doesn't work right away, then I suggest to keep coming back because you need to make sure that it's validated here. So let's go ahead and click on this button and we'll see if we're updating. And so we are. So it didn't take long at all. Domain validation is successful. So this final bit that you're going to see here is a DMARC record. So there's a couple of ways in which you can do this. Now, DMARC is basically telling the internet what to do with email that isn't properly authenticated. So in other words, if someone is sending email and it looks like it's from your domain, but it's a spammer, it's not going to pass this authentication here. And so what this does is it basically tells the internet, hey, what do we do with this? So this is a mandate or a requirement now by Google and Yahoo to have this record in. So ConvertKit actually gives you one. Now you can go ahead and sign up to Demartian or Postmark and get one of these records as well, which is what I do. They're free services as well. They're also paid services to essentially let you know via email what's happening, right? So if someone is doing that and being a little bit malicious, you can then go ahead and take further action. But Google and Yahoo basically say, we need a DMARC record with a P equals none just to abide by their requirements. So you're going to create a text DNS record with DMARC and then this value. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and do that right now and we'll be all set. Your verified sending domain is now set up inside of ConvertKit. You actually even have a DMARC record, which isn't required for verified sending domain in ConvertKit, but it helps you with the requirements that are on the web at this point in time. So now you've got your verified sending domain valid, at least on ConvertKit side. Right, you get that check mark, you're good to go. But let's just test. Let's make sure everything works. So what you're going to do is take a broadcast and send it to yourself. Send an email to yourself. If you have access to a Gmail inbox, this is going to work real simple for you. And I encourage you to test there. But if not, similar thing to test on Apple Mail or any other mail client. You'll be able to test this as well. So I'm going to go hop into my Gmail account because I've already sent a message to myself. So when you come into Gmail and you actually look at the email that you sent to yourself, go to the header and go to these three dots. Find show original. Now, when you show original, you're going to see right at the top, the three things that we set up, DMARC, DKIM, and SPF, all pass. So we're good to go, okay? This will show and this will validate that Google and everyone else also sees that our emails are authenticated, we're a verified sender, and so on and so forth. If you don't have Gmail, you can also find this information inside of Apple Mail, inside of Outlook. Any mail client has these where you're going to want to look for the option of view headers, show raw, things like that. And what you're going to look for are the SPF, DKIM, and DMARC, and look for the word pass. Okay. Now, there's another way you can check it, and it's called either DMARCian or Demartian. I like Demartian just because it's fun. I apologize if I'm pronouncing it wrong, but you can go ahead to this website and I'll link it in the description, but it's demartian.com. And then we could put our domain in and it'll tell us if our domain is set up properly for authentication. So I'm going to put this one in. Okay, and we're going to check my domain. Now, immediately you're going to be presented with this. And that's going to happen with this setup. So it doesn't mean anything that it's not working, but when you scroll down here, you'll see some X's and checkboxes. Now, the reason why I highlighted this one is because even though DKIM is set up, it wasn't set up in the past. And this website didn't pick up on the new setting. So let's talk about the X here first. If we expand details, we'll see that the DMARC is set up. And even here, your domain has a valid DMARC record, but the DMARC policy does not prevent abuse. And that's what that call to action up top said. So we're good to go as far as authentication for a DMARC record. Now, SPF looks good. Now, DKIM, it says we couldn't find a DKIM record associated with your domain if you know the correct selector. So the selector is CKA in this case, and it may be for yours as well because it's coming from ConvertKit authentication. If you select inspect DKIM, you'll see that it's found. Okay, so you're all tested. We tested through the inbox. We tested through a third party. You're authenticated at this point. Leave a question below if you have any hiccups or things that I can help with. And as always, when you treat your email lists like humans, amazing transformations happen.